conversation by using the video conferencing. Okay. Okay, various examples: Skype, Zoom, Gmeet, Google Meet, GoToMeeting, and many other examples are there nowadays. I think Microsoft Meet is also there. Okay, then Skype is there.
Google Meet.
Google Meet is there. So various platforms are available which we can use to do the video conferencing. Blogs. How many of you are using blogs? I'm not using. Yes, Pranay. What do you mean by blog? Why we use it?
Ma'am, it is used to share the...
It is used to share?
Ma'am, our opinions or views.
Correct. It is used to share your opinions or ideas with...
Anonymous
text
with the world
text form
in a text form. It could be in a text form. Mostly it is in a text form. Okay, we can share our views and ideas, okay, on a particular topic or with the people around us or with the people around the world. Kahin bar bhi same thought or same process ke groups bana ke, ya we can put our blogs, we can put our messages, we can put our post on the bulletin boards, and everybody can read it, can view it, and can give the response to it. They can reply to your blogs. They can give more information about your posts. They can mostly these are used to be connected with the people, or mostly it is used to share your views about the incidents around you or about the happenings around you, or whatever thoughts that comes to your mind and you want to share it with the world, with the people around you, you can post it on a blog. Okay, mostly people can use it for business purpose also, to connect with the various buyers or sellers also. So it refers to an online diary or journal where users can post any of the topic of his or her interest, and it is a short version of web log. And examples of blogs are WordPress, Blogger.com, Greatest, NerdWallet, CoinDesk, and many others are available. Okay, so blogs are used to put your thoughts, to put your views, to anything that you want to type, anything that you want to share, any view that you want the public, jo hai, jo around the people, jo aapke aas paas hai, ya kahin par bhi hai, they should read it and they can read it. Okay, Wiki. That is your a kind of encyclopedia. It refers to a set of one or more linked web pages which the readers can add or modify. Microblogging. Microblogging means it is a combination of blogging as well as instant messaging. It allows the users to post the short messages instantly. Instantly means messages to the users who are presently online. That is why it is called instant messaging. Instant messaging means instant. We send the message, online users are viewing it and giving us the reply. So it is a combination of blogging as well as instant messaging. For example, Twitter. We put any thought on a Twitter, instantly wahan pa reply and start ho jate hain. How many of you are using Twitter? How many of you are using Twitter for any purpose? Anyone who is using Twitter or having an account on Twitter? No one? Yes? No one is using Twitter?
Not me.
Yes? Okay. Next is document sharing service. Document sharing service, it includes all the tools that allows the creation and sharing of documents. We can create the documents online, we can create the files online, and we can share them with the people with whom you want to share. So for example, Google Docs, all these are the various communication medias that we are using nowadays for communicating, for transferring the information. So document sharing means ek ne document banaya, other people can share it. Google Docs, they can also edit it. ठीक है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल देर वॉज एन एप्लीकेशन फॉर क्रिएटिंग प्रेजेंटेशन और फॉर क्रिएटिंग प्रोजेक्ट सम वीडियो प्रोजेक्ट आर देयर. ऑनलाइन एप्लीकेशन आर अवेलेबल. ठीक है. यू कैन मेक अ ग्रुप ऑफ थ्री और फोर पीपल्स और मेनी पीपल एंड ऑल द पीपल कैन कंट्रीब्यूट टू द सेम प्रोजेक्ट बाय सिटिंग एट देयर ओन प्लेसेस. यू मेड सम चेंजेस, यू क्रिएटेड वन और टू स्लाइड्स. ठीक है. यू सेव इट, क्लोज इट. अदर पर्सन कैन लॉग इन द सेम अकाउंट एंड विद हिज और हर अन अकाउंट, अपने अकाउंट के साथ लॉग इन करेंगे. बट यू अलाउड देम टू शेयर द योर वर्क, यू अलाउड देम टू एडिट द वर्क, सो दे कैन ओपन योर वर्क, ओपन द सेम फाइल, मेक द चेंजेस, एड अ न्यू थिंग्स एंड सेव इट. सो अदर पर्सन आर ऑल्सो डूइंग दैट. सो इज दिस वे वी आर डॉक्यूमेंट शेयरिंग सर्विसेज आर अवेलेबल, लाइक कैनवा हो गया, विस्मे हो गया. Many applications are available, which are online available, on which you can create your video projects and presentations, which other people can also contribute to edit them. Okay. Next is topic, what is computer? This we had already discussed in the beginning. It is an electronic device that accepts the input from user, process the input and display the desired output. So according to the definition, we are having four functions of computer. Input, process, storage, output. So IPOS, first of all, it was IPO, IPO, input, processing, output. That is a cycle which the computer follows. We give the input, it will do the processing and it gives the output. That is IPO. Now, whatever input we are giving or whatever output we are getting, we want to store it also. So we added one more function, storage. So input means, yes, anyone? Input means
the raw information given by the user.
Correct. The data and information that we enter into the computer in the form of text, in the form of numbers, in the form of instructions, in the form of mouse clicking, all that is input. So various devices which are used to give input to the computer, they are called input devices. Input is the data or information that we enter into the computer, that is called input. Processing means the work or the calculation done by the computer on our input. Output means the final result or the information that we get after processing of computer, that is called output. Various storage device, various output devices, various devices that show us the output, that show us the result after processing, they are called the output devices. So, and we need one processing device also to do the processing. Storage, to store the data, that means to store the data permanently so that we can give an access, we can have an access to that data whenever required. That means that various storage devices are used to store the data. Okay. Memory. What do you mean by memory? Like we all are having memory. Short-term memory, long-term memory. Yes. What do you mean by memory? Anyone? Yes? No one? What do you mean by memory? Memory
is the place where we can store the data.
Ability to store the data. Memory means a place where we can store the data, or memory is the ability to store the data. Like we have the ability to store our information, what we are learning in one class. We have the memory. We know the way from our home to our school. So we had memorized that way. We had stored that information in our memory. So memory is the storage brain of computer which holds the data during the processing. During processing, whatever input is given, whatever partial results or intermediate results are there, and what will be the final result, all these things can be stored in the memory of the computer. And storage unit of is responsible for storing any kind of information permanently. So we can have the primary memory, which will store the data temporarily during the processing. And we can have the storage units or the secondary memory where we will store the data permanently that we want to access later on also. Okay. Okay. We will continue with this topic tomorrow. Okay. In today's topic, we had done only this much functions we had done. So tomorrow we will start with the storage units or processing units. Okay. Any doubt in today's topic?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you.